Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, thank you for tuning into yet another episode of The Switch It Up Show. My name is Glenn, and I am, of course, joined by my wonderful, stupendous, tremendous co-host, Mr. At Seth Trav. How are you today, this fine, fine evening?
I'm doing really well, man, and I gotta go fast because you and I got some great, great games today that all involve a little bit of speed.
Oh, my man, you know what? Its speed is in the title of each one of our games, you know, but they do say that speed kills, and that might be a little bit of a segue into our first game, but first, ladies and gentlemen, we might be going fast, but we're not going fast enough that we're going to skip over these sweet beats. Ladies and gentlemen, you always got to leave them wanting more. That's why I went ahead and ended that a little early. And if in fact you do want more, I highly suggest that you check out the show notes for the link to those wonderful, wonderful tunes. And, you know, also the link to the great, great YouTube of the Preach Network where you can catch gameplay of all these games and much, much more, hosted by yours truly, Mr. Seth Trav, whose computer is either frozen or he is staring off into space. And you know
I'm
what?
I'm here, baby.
My man, you know, I wasn't really sure. I thought you might have passed on to yet another life, the afterlife. But you know what, my man? You might think to yourself that afterlife sounds lonely. It is not, because luckily there is a service for all of those passed on to the nether world, and it is called Speed Dating for Ghosts, and it is available now in the eShop for $6.99. Let me hit you with a little bit of the synopsis here, and let me take 1 second to just go ahead and pat myself on the back for that beautiful transition, because that was so good. Branching dialogue, hard choices, a cemetery's worth of phantoms, wraiths, and poltergeists looking for love in all the blight places. Have you ever wanted to have deep, meaningful conversations with a smoldering poltergeist who terrorizes rich men in Vegas? How about a ghost dog looking for his owner? Or maybe you'd rather rob a bank? Ghosts are into all sorts of things, part horror, part comedy, and kinda sorta heartbreaking. Speed Dating for Ghosts is a game like no other, that about finding companionship and the closure in the afterlife. Meet more than a dozen ghosts of oh so many backgrounds, genders, and time periods. Learn how they died, as well as how they lived, and help them find peace if they like you enough to open up first. Based on what you say and how you say it, some dates might turn ugly. Not everyone gets along, even in the afterlife. Rue Morgue's best indie game of 2019 is finally on the Nintendo Switch. For the first time, you can date Gary, Hattie, Kayo, and so much more other spooky customers on the bus, on the couch, in a library, wherever you take your game. This is categorized as other / roleplaying / simulation, brought to us by the wonderful people over at Laundry Bear Games. That's a great production company. I just really wanted to go ahead and say that out loud. Laundry Bear, I like that. Speaking of things I like this game. My man, I see you over there enamored with this review.
It is very good. This game was incredible. The descriptions you used for it were you know, spot on. I was surprised by the heartbreaking nature of this game.
Dude,
a little bit.
It comes out of nowhere, and they were kind enough to provide us with two codes. So this is a game that you and I both got our hands on, and this is great, because the next episode is also like another game that's kind of like a visual novel. This is more of a visual novel / choose your own adventure. There are way more choices available in this game, which is great, because I really do like. Like, I think the dialogue is, like, snappy. It's, like, a good back-and-forth banter. I did find myself wanting to go back and replay some parts to find out how, like, you know, how, like, the dates would have went if you made other choices.
And the amazing part of this game is that they let you do that by going to that, like, graveyard section you have from... I guess it's like the gravestones or the markers for the people that you just went on the date with, and it lets you go back and go to that date and make different choices.
Yeah, dude,
which is amazing.
Dude, I think that's awesome because, like, you know, like time is at a premium. I'm sure for many of us, myself included, and there are a lot of times where I'm like, oh, that's cool, but I don't necessarily have the time to go back and like play the same thing again. Like, so I love being able to do that in this one. But like, I felt like myself like getting attached to some of these characters, and some of them kind of hit you with something that comes out of absolutely nowhere. Did you go, when they give you the first choice and you get to go to the couple different rooms in the very beginning, which room did you go to?
I went to the very first one, the furthest on the left.
Ah, okay. I think I went to the black room, which is the furthest on the right. Did you meet Gary at all?
I did not. I met the football player. I met the lady in smoke. And I met the triangle person.
Oh, that's cool. We all met completely different people. I did meet Gary. Yeah. I met Hattie. And I met this other, like, cool, like, punk chick. I think. Check. I don't know. It's hard to tell. This is
very androgynous.
It super is, because you have no idea kind of like which way these people, you know, these like ghosts are, like who are, what they are. They're all really weird looking.
They're all designed around like personality traits, it seems.
Yeah, but
which is cool.
But it's interesting because I feel like I haven't gone on a, like, you know, a date like a very long time, but like I would feel like, you know, in this game, people, like, the ghosts are holding back something, like, when you first start to talk to them. And then if you end up actually going out on the date, or also just, like, reading the story of said date, you know, if you choose to go out with them, like, you know, something, like, at least in my instance, comes out of left field, and I'm like, whoa, this is not what I was buying into. Ghost. I won't spoil it with which ghost. Kind of took me by surprise. But I like this. I like this game. This is fun. It's $6.99, and it is definitely more of a choose-your-own-adventure / visual novel. I played another visual novel game I'm going to be reviewing on the next episode, and that was really just so much of a novel and just really no choices, and I feel like this is a great balance. And the story is unique and fresh enough that it keeps my interest and wants me going back to play for more. For $6.99, I'm super, super happy with this. I'm gonna give this like a 4.5 out of 5, my man. This is like almost nice. This is almost perfect. Because you're getting value for your money. It's something different. I love the ghosts and everything. I just think it's super cool. And then it's speed dating for ghosts on the Nintendo eShop.
I was gonna say, I would also give it a 4.5. The amount of visual novels that we have played, and just the level of, I don't even know if it's detail. I guess it is detail. The amount of care and, attentiveness that they put into this game, for what it looks like, for what it is, it's amazing. Really, really a good time. Almost like this speedy good time of Speedrunners. It is available now, and it is $14.99 on the Nintendo eShop. Grapple your friends to outrun them in this competitive multiplayer platformer. In a city filled with superheroes, getting to crimes becomes a competition on its own. Fortunately, there are enough rockets, bombs, grappling hooks, spikes, and other goodies lying around to make the competition fun and fast. Welcome to Speedrunners! Speedrunners is a four-player competitive platformer with grappling hooks, power-ups, and interactive environments. Run, jump, swing around, fire rockets, and grapple onto your opponents to knock them off screen. It is from our good, good friends over at Tiny Build Games and developed by the fine folks over at Double Dutch Games. So, this game is breakneck speed running. Like, if you had a Mario Kart game, but you were like, instead of, you know, driving carts, why aren't you just the Flash? And that's it. Like, that is really, really it. And they hold to this superhero theme. There is a storyline where it allows you to unlock different costumes, different weapons, different power-ups. different characters to play as. Tons and tons and tons of unlockable things. The music is fun. The humor is kitsch. It's got a real, like, you know, like the animatics or storyboards for Pixar movies. It's got a real vibe of that. Like, and I really love that. Like, I could see these being, like, the tossed away ideas from an Incredibles movie. You know? Like, they were like, we're gonna have to leave this one on the floor. They're like, oh, we'll pick that up. Make it a game called Speedrunners. So, I definitely dig the vibe of this. Like I said, it was wildly captivating. You really get invested and into this, like, running and breakneck speed mentality. Basically, how it works is you go around this level in a circle, and you're platforming and running and jumping and sliding up and down walls as you try to trip up your opponent. The way you trip them up is... No, never mind. What happens is once they trip up, you run further away from them, and then they hit the edge of the level, a la Smash Brothers, and then they explode. Then what happens is this red border fills up the level, and it just keeps getting tighter and tighter and tighter, and the object is for you to outrun everyone. And once you do, they all explode, and the light shines on you, and you win! You get to save the day, because you're the hero of this city! And it's cool. So, ladies and gentlemen, because of all of these awesome, amazing, captivating things, plus a versus mode that I haven't even checked out yet, I imagine playing with your buddy would be the most fun thing. Again, a la Mario Kart, I am going to give Speedrunners a 4.5 out of 5.
That's a high...
Great games today, my man.
Oh, definitely, my dude. 5.5 out of 5. That is like...
4.5.
That is like high praise.
At 4.5, not 5.5.
Oh, well, I mean, 5.5 would be the highest of praise. Like, you can't...
Yeah, that'd be... Those are Meltzer numbers. That's inflated for the crowd.
That's six stars, is that what that is?
Six stars.
That's it, my
it's
man.
It's a seven-star matchup from the One-Winged Angel.
Oh, that's it. Oh, I'm not a big fan of that move.
No?
No. No, but that's one of the beautiful things about, you know, wrestling, about life, about video games. You know, if things ever get boring, you can always switch it up.